please, for the love of goodness, stop calling things souls-like or souls-clone. You're just setting yourself up for disappointment. It's getting super annoying. What is up, guys? Welcome back to Gaming in the Garage. You didn't like that? I am the Chivalrous Toaster here with...
Techno Dark Souls?
Yeah. So today we're going to be talking about a game that's coming out. It's supposed to come out in May. It just says May 2017 right now.
May never going to come out ever. Yeah. 2017.
It's called The Surge. It is being titled, when I don't like this, but as Sci-Fi Dark Souls. We'll throw up like a minute of gameplay here that we got from somebody. We'll leave the link down because I don't remember. We'll leave the link down to that so you can watch the full. It's like 18 minutes. It looks pretty cool. So, first, before we talk about that, I wanted to discuss the terms Souls Clone and Souls Like. This game, The Surge, is from the same developers that made Lords of the Fallen, Deck 13. And I think the thing that ultimately made that game a disappointment overall for most people, because they called it a Souls clone or Souls like. And when they went into that game expecting Dark Souls, they were disappointed because it was slower than Dark Souls, and overall it was just not as good as Dark Souls. I don't think it's good to compare other games to this game that you play over and over and over and over again.
It's kind of the same thing that happened to Battleborn, is it got compared to Overwatch, and it kind of killed that game.
Yeah, and I think people liked Lords of the Fallen, but I think their player base was the Dark Souls player base.
Yeah.
And the Dark Souls player base love Dark Souls. And
that's it.
They want to compare. They can't not compare things to Dark Souls.
You see this Call of Duty level? It's hard. It's basically Dark Souls.
Yeah, no. Ripped but right they're out like, of Dark Souls. Oh, this game's like 2D Dark Souls. This game's like, there's, I think it's called like Salt and Sanctuary or whatever. Like, yeah. It's Dark Souls with mouse. You can't keep comparing things to Dark Souls, because no game is going to be as good as Dark Souls. Especially because a lot of these games are coming from indie developers or developers like Deck 13 who aren't very big.
Yeah,
because
small developer teams.
Other AAA developers know that Bandai Namco and From Software have that niche. And they're not willing to try and, or to take the risk to try and take some of that player base away and gain some of their own in the process. So, when an indie developer, a smaller developer like Deck 13, goes, takes the risk, and tries to make a difficult but fair action RPG like Dark Souls, it ultimately gets compared to it. And I think that could be the downfall of this game, like it was for Lords of the Fallen. And I just don't want that to happen. And I want to get rid of the term Souls-like, Souls-clone completely, because, one, it's annoying. It sounds stupid. Same as Soulsborne, sounds stupid. But it's just not helpful to those games. Those games are their own games. Lords of the Fallen isn't like Dark Souls. It has the similar ideas as Dark Souls. It's Lords of the Fallen. The Surge isn't sci-fi Dark Souls. It's The Surge. We have... Do you have something to add here?
I think that it can hurt and it can help. If you look at Neo, I think that with Neo, it helped because people saw that it was basically Samurai Dark Souls and people thought that was cool and people bought it. But I also think that it can hurt in the case of Lords of the Fallen, so it's going to be interesting to see. I think what's really going to hurt this game the most is how under-marketed it is.
I found out about this game. I was watching... I'm going to pick up Lords of the Fallen soon. It's like $6 on
GTA.
It's not
bad for like $6.
And it looks really good.
It's not bad.
I found this out by just... It was in one of those one of the recommended videos, and I clicked on, oh, The Surge is made, it's from Deck 13, the people who made Lords of the Fallen. I checked it out. This game looks really cool. I'd never heard of it before. And we have some articles that we'll talk about here in a second. This game was announced back in 2015. So it's been at least in development. I think Lords of the Fallen came out in 2014. Yeah, or so maybe late 20 or early 2015.
So you've been about 3 years, so, 2 years, yeah, something like that.
About 2-3 years of development. And this is the first I'm hearing about it. And all the videos, it's only like a couple hundred thousand views on a channel like IGN.
Mm-hmm.
Which, you know, you'd expect to get lots more views than that. This game doesn't have a whole lot of marketing, which is disappointing.
I mean, to be honest, I don't remember hearing anything about Lords of the Fallen either, though. No,
it just kind of came out, and that's unfortunate, but we're trying, this game, we have till May, we're going to try and drum up some hype for this game like Deck 13 is trying to, because they're releasing stuff quite often now, and we're hoping that we can get some more people interested in this game, but if you look up this game, you can't find anything that doesn't consider it Dark Souls-esque.
Yeah.
All of the articles I found, the first one, the one that made me want to make this video, is from PC Games, and the title, this was from this year, this article, The Surge is a futuristic Dark Souls clone, but a dang fine one. But they didn't say dang.
No, they didn't.
That's the title. Already they're trying to say like,
wait,
oh, it's like Dark Souls, to get people to click on it. They want people to come and see this and expect Dark Souls. You're already setting them up for disappointment, because this game, I can already tell you, probably won't be better than Dark Souls. Probably won't be, it'll probably be better than Dark Souls 2, I'm guessing, but it's nowhere near Dark Souls 1 level. It'd be so hard.
To any of those Dark Souls fans out there, is any game, I mean, like...
Exactly.
They could play any game, and it could be, like, an awesome game. You know, I'm just going to back play Dark Souls.
They don't like Bloodborne, which I think is the most beloved game besides Dark Souls 1. Bloodborne
is great.
I don't. But that's, like, the most beloved one for the really big fans of From Software. And they don't even consider that one to be better than Dark Souls 1. So, another thing that's, I think, a little bit sad is the creative director, at least, his name, or her name, I don't know, I couldn't find out. Oh, it's Jan Close, but they're German, I don't know. Here's what they said. They're in PC Games and article, they have a couple of quotes from them. There's a very good reason that The Surge can't seem to escape comparisons to From Software's franchise. And it's a simple one. It borrows relentlessly from it. PC Games N says they borrow relentlessly from the Dark Souls franchise. Lords of the Fallen, you could kind of make that
to a comparison. Point. Yeah.
But in this game, there's not a whole lot similar to the Dark Souls franchise, except for the difficult combat, the fact that you need a resource to level up.
Mm-hmm.
In this one, I'm pretty sure they just call it XP. They might change it in fall release, but like pre-alpha footage, they called it pre-alpha, but I doubt it.
Yeah,
they I think it was just XP
coming out in May. Then yeah,
and then the other thing is the backstepping, which seems very Bloodborne. Much more like Bloodborne. At least the character movement seemed a lot more like Bloodborne. But here's the creative director, here's what they said. We were not comparing ourselves to the Souls series, but more to Lords of the Fallen. Surprisingly, many people don't say that The Surge is a science fiction Lords of the Fallen, but instead they say it's a science fiction Dark Souls. It's like, come on, we already did that game, we're trying to evolve from that. So they don't like the comparisons because they know what it did to Lords of the Fallen. They know, you go watch so many YouTube videos about it, and they're like, it's like slow, clunky Dark Souls. It's like a crappy version of Dark Souls. They wanted to change it. They didn't want to make Dark Souls. because you can't recreate Dark Souls.
No.
The only people that can do that is From Software. And clearly from Dark Souls 2 and 3, not even they are very good at doing it without Hidetaka Miyazaki. They want to make their own game,
mm-hmm.
but have it be a difficult action RPG.
Yeah, but I think as soon as you add a steep difficulty like that, you're going to get comparisons to Dark Souls. It's just inevitable. And
honestly, it's so annoying because clearly they think that it made people dislike Lords of the Fallen.
It did. I think Vidya himself called it Clunky Souls.
That's what his video, the thumbnail was. Here's the thing. They want to separate themselves even further from Dark Souls than Lords of the Fallen. I'm pretty sure they wanted to make Lords of the Fallen too. But
probably
they're trying to separate themselves as much as they can, but still remain in this difficult action RPG realm.
Mm-hmm.
But let's see if other people can try and not compare this to Dark Souls. I don't think it's possible. 2015. This is the earliest article I could find about it. It's from Polygon. The Surge is a sci-fi spin on Dark Souls and from the Lords of the Fallen team. Again, Dark Souls. But what about our Lord and Savior over at IGN?
Wait. No. You gotta do it like the trailers where for all the games where they're like, alright, 10 out of 10, IGN.
The Surge
is succeeding at being more than a sci-fi Dark Souls. 10 out of 10, IGN.
Really? And then from Rock, Paper, Shotgun, The Surge brings limb theft to the Dark Souls party. None of them could compare it to anything but Dark Souls. In the Rock, Paper, Shotgun article, they said, is The Surge a good sci-fi Dark Souls? Like, they couldn't not compare it to Dark Souls. They couldn't help themselves.
Mm-hmm.
And honestly, if their whole marketing is sci-fi Dark Souls, the only people that are going to go play it is Dark Souls fans.
Yep.
And they're going to be disappointed.
Yep.
And call the game crap.
Yep.
And I watched a bunch of videos, and they're all like, this game looks crap. This game sucks. For pre-alpha footage of a game they hadn't played.
Mm-hmm.
You can't do it. You can't do that, because then this game is going to fail and nobody will be willing to do it except for indie developers, and their games kind of suck when they try and do it. There's only a few good games like Dark Souls that are made from indie developers. But, okay, let's go back to the borrowed relentlessly, which was the thing that made me so angry. I got so triggered, you could say, from it. So the sidestep, that was borrowed, you could say, from Bloodborne.
Mm-hmm.
It not Dark Souls, because it definitely looks like Bloodborne. If you watch the gameplay, it's Bloodborne. You jump into the combat, attack really fast, and then jump back out. And then you're dashing from side to side to try and avoid the attacks instead of dodge rolling, like in Dark Souls. It's difficult. It's a difficult action RPG, like Dark Souls. Like Dark Souls, you need to explore the world to receive items and shortcuts throughout it. And then the resources required to level up. There's not a whole lot more they took from Dark Souls. Let's see what you should go into this game expecting. A nice sci-fi setting. The setting is probably like half the reason... It's more than half the reason why I'm excited for this game. I love the sci-fi genre, but I just think video games don't do it very well. You know, there's Mass Effect, and then, like, besides that, like, Fallout. Star Wars, I don't know. Besides that, there aren't a whole lot of good ones. But this game looks like it has a ton of potential. You can target individual limbs in this game. And instead of heavy and light attacks, there's vertical and horizontal. So you'll have to learn, like, how you can chop their limb off as fast as possible to kill them. I think that adds a bit of difficulty to the combat and more variety.
Yep.
But another cool thing, I don't know if you... I'll try and find a little piece of this and show it to you. You can target limbs that are armored, and you have a chance at receiving the armor blueprint or weapon blueprint as a drop if you kill them by attacking that piece of armor. It's difficult, but fair. Like a certain game we shouldn't talk about. And
Call of Duty?
Yeah. And what I think is best, coming from a developer who made a game that was compared so much to Dark Souls that it hurt it, they want to separate themselves from being a Dark Souls clone. That's what I think you should look forward to in this game. They don't want to be Dark Souls anymore. There's weapon crafting in this game. It's not very in-depth, at least what they showed in the gameplay trailer is pretty much like you had these items and you found the blueprint. There wasn't any. It's very basic. But it's still there, and it's interesting.
Seems cool.
They want to not be Dark Souls clones. So they're adding in, they're innovating. I love that word, because it's such a buzzword for gaming. They're like, we can make a crappy game and innovate. But they look like they're actually innovating and making a good game. But I just don't think that considering it a sci-fi Dark Souls clone is good for this game. I think that if we looked at this game as The Surge and not as sci-fi Dark Souls, this game has a better chance at being successful.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if you agree with me.
I'm just going to start calling it Techno Dark Souls just to bother you.
I seriously don't get it.
I mean, I think that you're going to have comparisons, and so you're going to find IGN, you're going to find GameSpot, you're going to find VODivia even, and they're all going to call it sci-fi Dark Souls. They're just going to call it that. And so it's kind of inevitable. I think what it should be is, if you like those kinds of games, maybe take this game as a look, but maybe lower your expectations a little bit, because maybe you've been playing a game for a little too long, and maybe you can't like another game. Maybe you just don't want to. Maybe a lot of these people just don't want to like another game. Maybe they just want all these games to fail because they're not Dark Souls.
Maybe, but that's a really crappy thing to be.
It is.
And
but
you talk, I mean, if this video gets like any amount of views from the Souls community, it'll be a bunch of dislikes from them because we're not talking about Dark Souls in the utmost respected way. At some point, you get bored of a game. And mm-hmm. I played Dark Souls 2 for like 200 hours. I played through it like 8 times. But Dark Souls 1, I couldn't get through it that much because it was boring. Dark Souls 3, I'm having the same problem. I'm like trudging through the game to get to the fun parts. And this new idea, sci-fi, difficult action RPG, is just bringing something fresh to a genre that I think is very boring right now. Because a lot of people are trying to make a Dark Souls clone, and even Bloodborne to me was more of a Dark Souls clone than its own thing. It was kind of boring to me.
It feels
very bland now. Like, everybody's just trying to make a kind of medieval action RPG.
Yep.
That's hard.
Yep.
And when people take a risk and do something like The Surge is, I think we could really have a lot of fun with it. But we just can't go in expecting Dark Souls level of level design, Dark Souls level of enemy variety, Dark Souls level of lore. You can't go in expecting any of that. You should go in having expectations of the developers and of the game. You can't
kind of having fun.
Yeah, I mean, honestly, you should expect,
maybe the game will be fun, and maybe you'll find another game you like.
You should expect to get $60 worth of content out of this game. You shouldn't go in expecting this game to be anywhere near Dark Souls level of polish, of just quality, because it won't be.
Nope.
But what I've done so I can get excited for this game is push Dark Souls out of my mind when I think about this game, because that has let me think about this game as its own thing instead of a Dark Souls clone. And that's what I hope we can convince the Souls community to do, because you have to realize that after the Ring City DLC, you're not going to get another Dark Souls until Bandai Namco, who owns the rights to it, decides to make another one, and it probably won't be FromSoft making it. It'll probably be somebody else.
Well, no, it'll probably be From Software with none of the people that made the other Dark Souls games.
Or even a slimmer chance Sony makes another Demon's Souls.
Yeah, that's pretty slim.
That's not going to happen, but no. It could. No. So you have to realize these other developers are trying to give you something to do, and it's coming out, I think, just it gives you enough time to get to suck all the content out of the Ring City DLC to May. You get to May, you should be done with it by then. And then you can go play this game. And I don't want to knock on Dark Souls. It's a great game. But I just want people to understand that just because a game is similar doesn't mean it's a Dark Souls clone. And that's what I think a lot of the popular YouTubers like saying that. They like it. And it's just not...
It's kind of clickbait. It gets people interested-ish.
But it's just not helpful.
No.
To these smaller games.
But it does get views, and that's what they care about.
That's not what we care about, because we don't get any.
So we can say stuff like this, because...
Vadi Vidya, you suck for calling Lords of the Fallen.
He called you out, Vadi. He called you out. Let's have a Dark Souls off.
That wouldn't be fun.
No.
But seriously, go check this game out. It is super cool. It is... Okay, I shouldn't talk it up a whole lot, because I've never played it. I've just seen gameplay. But
Just give it a chance. Let's just leave it at that. Give it a chance.
The rest of the song... Yeah. Honestly, if you have, like, 10 minutes... If you can spare 10 minutes to go watch gameplay, go see if you can watch just stock gameplay, because when they did, like, playtest at, like, Gamescom and stuff, it was really boring to watch, because they had to sit there and explain everything. And if...
Say, I know you hate it, but I think IGN probably had the best footage. So,
yeah,
just saying.
So go check out those videos. In fact, we'll leave a link to a couple of them down in the description so you can check them out. If you are a fan of Dark Souls, if you're a fan of just RPGs, and you're looking for something maybe to challenge you a little bit, look into The Surge. It could be a huge success if the Dark Souls fans get out of their huts a little bit and go check out something new. Please stop saying Souls clone. That's all we have, guys. If you liked the video, you know, subscribe to our channel. We'll be following The Surge a little bit. We hope they release new stuff soon so we can update you guys on what we think about the game. And you know what? It wouldn't hurt to leave a like on the video. Maybe that's the only thing that makes us feel good. That's it, guys. Catch you later.